Job opportunity. Caritas Ghana, in collaboration with the Archdiocese of Tamale, is going to establish a plastic pre-processing plant in Tamale. Caritas Ghana is looking for 4 suitable machine operators. The machine operators shall have a basic pre-tertiary technical competence in machine operation. The machine operators must be very reliable and must have to work very carefully with a great sense of responsibility. If interested, kindly send your application to tado.tamale@yahoo.com or the development coordinator, Tado, Catholic Archdiocese of Tamale, Post Office Box TL42, Tamale. The application should be submitted before or on Friday, 4th January 2021. Interviews shall be held on 7th and 8th January 2021. Remember, the machine operators will receive comprehensive induction training into their specific jobs.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised, and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
The Baya.
Asam.
Yedafi.
Tipuhoya.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome you to the Living Streams of Water. Today, Friday, weekdays of Advent, 18th December, we shall reflect on the gospel of the day. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory be to you, O Christ. The birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to send her away quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, in the Gospel passage of today, it explains how the birth of Jesus Christ took place. His mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph. Among the Jews, my dear brothers and sisters, betrothal had a force that backed it, such that the fiancé was already called husband and could release himself from the engagement only by an act of repudiation or refusing to accept the act. This was the situation in which Joseph found himself. But before they came to live together, Mary was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, we are told in the Gospel, being an upright man and wanting to spare Mary from disgrace, decided to divorce her informally, that is, to put her away from him privately. Joseph, from this situation of Mary, was discouraged from proceeding with the marriage by respect for the mystery of Mary's motherhood, and has to be convinced by means of an angel's message. That is, that it is still God's will that he should take Mary as his wife. God makes his intention known in a dream to Joseph, in order to let the one who is to save mankind, come to fulfill the promise of God through the prophet Isaiah, to let our Savior, or the Savior, come to live among us. In our preparation for Christmas, my dear brothers and sisters, God wish to bring to our minds, or wish to remind us, and also help us to be aware that it is his wish to bring us all out of our difficulties, problems of life that makes us worried or sad. And it's only one thing that he requires of us to be able to bring us to this destination. And this is that we should be listeners. We should be good listeners. That is, to listen when he speaks to us. How does God speak to us? How does he do this to us? First, God speaks to us through our conscience. Our conscience, we are told, is the voice of God. God directs us through our conscience. In the church, where we hear His word, God speaks to us through His word. In the Bible, which we are encouraged to read always, there God also speaks to us. In the good advices, or in good advice we receive from relatives and friends, are all ways that God communicates, God directs us, and God wishes to free us from our difficulties, from our confusions of life. My dear brothers and sisters, Saint Joseph, as the reading today was centered at, who cooperated with the will of God that the Savior came to live, came to dwell among us, listened to the voice of God. He listened when the angel spoke to him. He was set free from his state of confusion by heeding to the words of the angel. And by this, Saint Joseph became and is a companion of Christ. He cooperated with Christ and he joined Christ in letting the will of God come to completion, come to a realization in our lives. Do we expect that God will always listen to us when we do not listen to Him? Should we always expect that God should always listen to us when we do not listen to Him? God calls us to give Him the listening ear, that He may draw us closer to Him. May we never be afraid, my dear brothers and sisters, and always be obedient when God speaks to us. May we be obedient when God speaks to us and never be afraid to listen to God or to approach God that He may direct us. May this day that God Himself has called us, is beckoning us to give a listening ear to Him as we prepare for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, grant us the grace that in humility we may let the will of God be done in our lives. That is just by listening to Him and obeying what He tells us. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace and remain in the love of God.
Caritas Ghana, in cooperation with the Archdiocese of Tamale, is going to establish a plastic reprocessing plant in Tamale. Caritas Ghana is looking for 14 suitable recycling assistants. They would be responsible for 1. Inspecting and weighing incoming plastic waste, 2. Sorting, separating, and cleaning of the incoming plastic, 3. Performing other duties as assigned from time to time. If interested, kindly send your applications to tado.tamale@yahoo.com or the Development Coordinator, Tado, Catholic Archdiocese of Tamale, Post Office Box TL42, Tamale. The applications should be submitted before or on Friday, 4th of January 2021. Interviews shall be held on the 7th and 8th January 2021. Remember, all the 14 recycling assistants will receive intensive training in their various duties.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
Tepaya.
Asankush. Yedasi.
Tepuhoya.